Hello, Inspi family, and welcome to another episode of the Inspiwords podcast. I'm your host, Toby Sindaba, and today I have Mango. Mango Ngobese. She's a brilliant performer. She's an actor. She is a singer. She is a worshiper. She is a child of God. She's done one of the songs that you've probably danced to. You've probably played on your phone. It's probably part of your playlist. And today you get to hear the story behind the song.
Mmangaliso Ngobese is a 23-year-old born in a small town called Greytown. It's in KZN for those who don't know. She is a theatre performer and singer. She has strong skills in theatre performance and musical theatre. Her excellence won her a Johannesburg Operatic and Dramatic Society Prize. As a student who has made the most distinguished contribution on stage in the Johannesburg Operatic and Dramatic Society School of Music Production. Mmangaliso's love for singing has opened her opportunities to collaborate with local artists and perform in various events. Last year, September, she released her debut single, Ngilinde, which captured the hearts of South Africans as it made it to the top 5 music charts in South Africa. Mmangaliso continues to work harder and strives to sharpening her craft and make a big name for herself in the industry. How about that?
I'm good. I'm breathing. I can't breathe. I'm a little bit nervous.
Why? Like, I wouldn't expect someone like you to be nervous about this.
Oh, please. No. You cannot be nervous.
You performed in big stages, eh? You can't be nervous about something like this.
No, I get nervous all the time.
How do you deal with the nerves?
I don't know if I deal with them. I just do what I have to do, and then I'm like, oh, okay, I'm done. Oh, okay.
So we can do that even today.
Yes, like, yes.
Just do what you have to do.
Yeah,
And I'm sure you will do very well. Like you are one person that I don't have to worry about. Sometimes I get guests, that I feel like, okay, this one, we might have to prepare them.
Yeah.
But they also surprise me.
Yeah.
Because I feel like I like talking about safe spaces.
Yeah.
So this is a safe space. In which you can be yourself and talk about, you know?
Yeah.
Whatever.
Thank you for that. Thank you for the safe space.
So the podcast, well, you know, because I spoke to you about it before.
You did,
The podcast actually started. And I wanted you to be one of the first people I interviewed. And you've denied me that opportunity.
I did.
But I'm so glad that finally we're able to do it.
Yeah.
So the podcast is about purpose, passion, and progress. And I want to understand from someone like you, I assume you are a passionate person, right?
Yes. Yes.
So how do you define passion?
Passion. I think it's such a, for me, that it's quite difficult to actually define what exactly passion is.
Mm-hmm.
But to put it in words, I think it's a call.
Call.
Yes, a calling. From anything.
Mm-hmm.
From anything you believe in, maybe as an individual.
Mm.
For me, I'd say it's a call from God. You know, He's calling me something. He's calling me to do something.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's something that you have to do. Like it's like an urge. It's like an urge. You know, for me, that is passion. I have to sing.
Is that what you're passionate about?
Yes, yes. I'm passionate about the arts. Like, I don't see myself not doing anything besides art.
Okay.
the funny thing is that it's a joke that I always say with my friends. Like, oh my word, I actually can't believe that we actually took this decision that we're gonna be in this department, that we're gonna do this thing for the rest of our lives.
Yeah,
you know. But I also say that it's within the hardships of our industry, but it actually shows that you have to have the passion for it in order for you to actually sustain yourself in it. You know what I mean? So for me, that is passion. It's basically what I do.
What about purpose?
Purpose. It runs around along the same the same lane. I don't think there's can't put them separate.
Okay.
Whenever there's purpose, there's passion. Whenever there's passion, there's purpose.
When did you come to understand that this is your passion, this is your purpose?
I think it was in my first year.
You're already in it?
I'm already in it.
Okay.
Because believe it or not, when I was in my first year, I was questioning myself. Like in the first semester, because I was doing something that I wasn't... It was new to me. The coursework, everything. I was just like, am I sure this is what I want to do? And I remember calling my mom. Mom, like, I feel like I'm doing medicine. Something that I was running away from. But here I am having to learn all these words, all these new content, you know. She spoke to me and she was like, no. Calm down. Learn what you have to learn, ask for help. And then I was like, okay, let me calm down. Maybe I'm just being dramatic, you know. And then I was like, okay. As I was, you know, learning stuff and participating in more projects, that's when I knew. I was like, okay.
Knowing your mom, you're talking about how your mom was calming you down.
Yeah.
Just tell me a bit about that relationship. Because I know your mom personally and she's like, a ball of joy, like she's very cool mom, like at least to me. I don't know if she's a cool mom to you, because she was also a police officer, so I don't know.
she's
tell me about that relationship.
We have a very close relationship with my mom. I can tell her, like, I can literally tell her anything.
Okay, like anything,
but obviously I choose. Obviously, I choose what to tell her, what not. So we just have that close relationship. We're very open. She's also pretty much open to me as well as her daughter, and also as her first daughter.
So the firstborn.
I'm the firstborn.
Nice.
Yeah.
you don't sound thrilled about being the firstborn.
No, it's not. It's not nice. It's not nice. I'm co-parenting here.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
How many siblings? Two sisters.
Two sisters.
Sure.
So I'm co-parenting. You know, because sometimes my mom would call me and say, "Ish, Mangayazi, I'm thinking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't know if I should tell the little ones." Or she's like, "Please tell them."
Yo. So
now it's my responsibility. You know,
adulting.
Even when there's issues at home, I have to be the one to be like, okay, guys, this is what's happening. Let's calm down. Let's do this. Let's do that. You know, so yeah, I'm her right hand woman there. And we have a very close relationship with my mom. And I think, I mean, she's the one who also pushed me to do this.
Yeah, I remember that story you told at Orange Farm.
Orange Farm, yes.
Give it to us. I think for me, it's interesting story. I'll tell you why. Give that story to us.
So obviously in my grade 11 matric, when we, you know, busy applying, I was still confused as to what exactly I wanted to do. I mean, not even that I was confused. I was just scared of saying, Mom, Dad, I want to do drama, I want to act, I want to be film, I want to, I was just scared. And then, especially because it wasn't a thing that I was familiar with, you know, I didn't do it in high school. There was no drama classes, there was nothing. I was literally in a maths and science school.
Sure.
I was doing physics, I was doing science, I was doing maths, you know? So I was like, okay, maybe I can do like sports, because, I mean, I was pretty much active in sports. I was like, okay, maybe I'll do like sports science. Okay, we'll see. I mean, I even followed Caster Semenya. I was like, okay, maybe I'll be the next Caster Semenya. Like 100 meters, I was there.
Yeah.
You know, and I'd even get those those trophies, kingy, Victrix Ladorum trophies for like being the fastest runner.
In our school, we didn't have those kind of things.
Well, we had that. So it was like a motivation
for me. And I remember, I think I saw online when I was doing research about this, you were in the news, in the newspaper.
Yes. Yeah. I was in the, so in my primary, St. David's. So in Greytown, there's a Greytown Gazette.
You know, if you went to St. Watwat, if you went to a good school.
No, I did.
My school wasn't that Tagus.
I know that school very well.
It's a good school. It produced a whole doctor.
Here not you
even
are.
One. I know another doctor that came from that school. So
you know. So yes, I got my Victor's Ladorum trophy from primary up to high school. So I was like, man, this is my calling. I'll just run, for the rest of my life. I'll go to Olympics. You know, I can start a career there. I was also looking at, maybe health science, maybe physiotherapy, things like that. Law, I was thinking of law, but I really wasn't 100% sure.
I can't imagine you doing law, eh?
Point of order.
Objection.
Objection, my lord. All those words that people say. But I was like, I'd like to play a lawyer. That's what I always said. At least because I didn't.
So you can
still
be a lawyer.
I can still be a lawyer. Yeah, well.
Actually, you can be so many things.
Exactly. That's what's fun about our industry. So in my high school, I was in an old girls boarding school, in Durban, in under seminary. Hi members, we called each other members. It's all members.
Wow.
So members.
Honorable members.
Yes. So. When every time I went back home, they'd ask, because are you applying? Yes, get apply. Okay. What are you applying for? Oh, no, ma, I was just thinking of law. Things like that. Or teaching.
Yo.
Or like linguistics. just let it pass and gee.
Yeah.
Okay, and then, I have one good CI. Something is not. And every time, they literally ask me, every time, like continuously, what's happening? I'm applying all these universities. And then this one day, my mom was like, Danam, I think we were praying. I think I was going to go back to school after holidays. I'm not exactly sure when exactly that was. And then my mom was like, you're in matric and, you know, you're busy applying and obviously you're working towards work and, you know, trying to figure out your career and stuff like that. But I want to tell you that you are free to do whatever you want to do. I literally froze and I looked. I was so scared. I was like, hey, bro, what is my mom saying now? And she's like, you're free to do whatever you want. I can't, Tina, as your parents, we can't stop you from going to something that you want to go for. You know what I mean? Yo, I was very scared. But when I heard that, there was some sort of relief. I was like, wow, okay. If you want to act, go act. If you want to sing, go sing. Do whatever you want to do. We know you. You are our daughter. You've been doing this thing.
And you
are
indeed your mother's daughter.
You know? You were doing these things from primary. And she'd always go back, like whenever we're having conversations about what I do, she'd always remind me of what I used to do in primary. Even when I was in a crash. There's a song that I sang. It was a solo. Father Abraham had many sons. Literally, I think that was my proper solo that I did from grade R. And then primary, I was always part of like closing concerts. And I was put as the main character. And I obviously didn't understand like why Mrs. Swanepoel asked me to be Mary, and then this other guy's gonna be Joseph. And I didn't understand. When I come back home, I'm excited. Okay. You know? choir was there from primary, Jay. You know, I'm obviously at church as well, even Maslangan as a family. Start a song, I'll jump and start a song, you know. So it started from when I was very, very young. It was just me that I didn't know.
But your mother knew.
She knew. And I think that was when she just confirmed it for me.
How powerful was that for you? Like, because for me, I think the reason why I wanted to go to the story is because often parents don't want their kids to go do acting.
True.
They don't want their kids to be in the arts because to them, it's not really a career.
Yeah.
You can't make a career out of it.
Yeah.
And for me, when you told that story, it was quite mind-blowing to see how parents are able to identify what is in their children. Like, you're a brilliant performer.
Thank you so much.
You are.
Thank
and,
you.
And to me, it was like your mom. There's something unique about a mother who can do that.
Yeah.
When, you know, mothers and parents generally would want their children to be lawyers.
Yeah,
they definitely. Would never discourage you from doing law and say, go to performing arts.
True. And you find that most of our colleagues or friends, they have to force themselves into the arts.
Sure.
You know, they have to maybe start somewhere or do art and then do something else.
I know people that have done that. Yeah, I know people that have done that. So how liberating was it for you to hear your mom saying you can do this, you can be whatever you want to be?
I mean, after hearing her say that, I mean, at first I was obviously like scared. I was like, yo, okay, so where to from here? You know, where to from here? But I was so relieved. You know, like I mentioned, I was so relieved. There was some sort of freedom in me. I was like, okay. Like it's like, you know, it's you know when you when people are holding like a dove or a bird like this, and then they set it free.
Sure.
I think that was that moment for me.
Mm.
And then I went ngavele ngayagu after. I think they replied like a day or two. Like, but it was within a week. Yes, we're accepting you. Hi, boy.
Wow.
Okay. And everyone is excited.
And big in SA,
it
right?
It is. Because, like, we were applying there with my friends and my classmates. So I was screaming, like, yay, AFTA accepted me. So I go back to my parents. Okay, so AFTA, this is what I need to do. I forgot what I needed to do next. And then they were like, okay, so AFTA is a private institution.
Oh.
Yeah, boy. We want you to do your thing, but let's try at a university. And then if, you know, in a year it's not what you're looking for, then we'll go back to AFTA. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. I wanted to be in Joburg. That's where the money is.
Of course. That's where the actors are.
You know, that's where the entertainment is at. So I was like, okay, I need to go to Wits. I applied to Wits. Okay, yes, my dear. You need to book for an interview and prepare a monologue. Whoa. wait a minute. What's happening here? Why? What's happening? Why do I need... Whoa. Luckily, I had my English teacher and my sports teacher. So they were both in... They had an idea of, you know, of the arts, you know, and obviously they were English. They both were English teachers, so it was easy for them to help me.
Yeah,
and I also had to find an African movie that I had to analyze. So it was all these things. I'm just like, oh, okay, I wasn't ready for this, but okay, let's do it. I'm asking my friends, okay, please watch me and give me notes, and I'd perform for them. You know, so it was a process. Hey, but I was scared. I was like, hey, yeah, now this thing. Now it was getting real. I was like, okay, now this is getting real. Yeah,
sure. You're
giving the bait, and now I have to work hard to get to where I want to be. And my audition was, I think it was around September. September, and was a Saturday. We go, my parent, my dad and my two little sisters, they come with me. My dad books a hotel there here nearby, Bram. I analyzed Wakanda. Because it was still fresh.
When was this?
Guys, this was 2018.
Oh, 2018. Okay.
Yes. So Wakanda was still fresh.
Black Panther.
No, not me saying Wakanda. Black Panther. Yes. So you know that woman, those women warriors, all those, all that content. I was, you know, busy, you know, focusing on those type of things. And then so I had to hand in that. They put us in room 207, and then the audition was in room 209.
Mm.
So I get inside, hey, all these people who studied at National Arts.
Oh yeah. School,
people who went to, yeah, all these schools that they did arts. They majored in drama. Hey, people are stretching. People are doing vocal warm-ups. People are busy. Like, they know their thing. They know their stuff. We're in this one room. I think there was like 20 of us, 20-ish. Girls and boys, we're mixed. Yeah, people are wearing stuff. They're all tights, shorts. You know, attire that is this fit for this. I mean, I was also quite comfortable because they did say you must, you know, wear comfortable clothes. Because after that, there's going to be something. So we did like a young workshop afterwards. Okay. But before I get to the workshop, so obviously I'm like stunned. Yo, all these people. Okay, cool. The interesting part is that everyone who came out of that audition room, they all had negative things to say. All of them.
Regardless of whether they went to the South African National School of Arts or not.
Everyone was just like, oh my word. When I went into that room, they asked me questions. They were asking me about the theory of what Stanislavski. And me, I'm just like, I do not know what that
Which
is.
Which one is that one?
I don't know. So if they ask me those questions, I don't know what I'm going to say.
Ish.
So already my chance here, hey, I don't know. I don't know where I'm sitting. It's just me and this monologue and my face at this moment. Then it's my turn. Okay. I'm like, okay, you know what? Just go in there and smile. Just give him the biggest smile ever.
Mm.
Just so you also calm yourself down, you know? I get there and I stand and I smile. I greet them with this biggest smile ever. Yo, Shema, I don't remember what I did.
You don't remember? You wouldn't want to do
it. No, I don't remember. No, I don't remember. I can't say it now. It was also like sort of a spoken word kind of a monologue. It wasn't like a monologue, you know what I mean? I do it. I finish. I'm done. Hey, man, I can feel the energy. They're impressed.
They liked you.
Yeah. They liked me, these guys. I'm like, I did my best. And then they're like, so why drama?
Yo. Big question. And I was going to ask that question.
Was I prepared for this? I don't think I was. But I was like, hey, now I have to put myself out there and actually. And then I was like, oh, yeah, I know my family's quite artistic. I got it from there. Primary, high school, I was always active. You know, I was always in the front line of anything creative. You know, I'm telling them all these things.
Mm.
And I'm like, and, you know, even with the things that I watch on TV, like I'm always interested in the things that I watch. There's always that excitement, you know. I tell them that. I tell them all those. Yeah, hey, I'm being creative on the spot. And then,
you are actually doing it.
I am doing
it right then.
And then they ask me, how am I going to survive? If it happens that they take me, like, how am I going to survive, you know, with the new content and all those things, something that I've never been exposed to before. Yo, and man, I'm like, yo, that's a really good question. But you know what? I'm willing to do this thing. And if it's really what I'm called to do, then I'm gonna do my best. And I'm actually gonna do it. I'm gonna make sure, I'm gonna ask help, I'm gonna consult. Hey, nyeshozonke lezinto lezi. I'm like, hey, mina, I'm willing, it's at it. I'm here for a reason, guys. Please. I don't wanna lie, my interview was so refreshing.
Mm.
It was so refreshing. They were asking the right questions. Okay, you want to do this. Why?
Mm.
You want to major.
Which is also important for you. Yes, it's also important.
Yes, definitely. And then there was this other question that they asked, what you want to major in.
Mm.
So whether it's directing or musical theater or writing. And when in my head, I was like, oh yeah, directing, yeah, I think yeah, directing, you know, because I have this creative mind, I'll be. But you know, when I look back now, I don't think I can ever be a director.
Why?
I don't think I have the capacity. I'm like, no, I was actually lying. I can't. The only thing I can direct is musically.
Mm.
Musical direction. I can do that.
Let's hold this here. We'll come back to the whole vets experience. Okay. I want to call your mom.
Oh. Wow. Okay.
I want to call your mom. I have her mother's number. I want to call your mom and ask her about this.
Okay.
I'm Kisa.
Savona Maninjan.
Yapila.
Siyaphila usemsakazweni.
Hayi bo Kisa, ngisemsakazweni.
Eh, usemoyeni, sawubona.
Yebo.
Ayi sazana, saphila kodwa.
Ngiyaphila bhuti, ngiyaphila kakhulu. Sengisaba nje ukuthi ngisemsakazweni. Sengabe ngishaya ivesi nje sengiyasaba.
Cha, nali ivesi lamukelekile vele.
Hayi, uma kusemsakazweni ke kufune ngathi ungathi ukujula kanje.
Wow, I was talking to Umango earlier and I'm in an doing an interview with her right now. She was telling me that you've just finished your studies. I just wanted to congratulate you.
We
are really so proud of you. We want to just congratulate you. And I heard Duguti say Upumile even in the force because you are pursuing this psychology thing.
Yeah, shame. God is good. God is good. God is good. It's like when you actually dream it, then it's there for you.
No, siyabong. So the other reason why I'm calling you an amane is that I'm doing a podcast. I'm sure Umango has told you about my podcast.
Right.
Yeah. So I'm doing a podcast episode with her. And she was just telling me, manje, Uguti, you are the one who encouraged her to do the arts.
I was
so surprised by that. Maybe Mkambe Ngabuza, it's Ngabuza now, Uguti. Why drama? Because she was telling me, Uguti, she was thinking around this into the law and all of that. What is it? Because abazali abaningi wouldn't do that. Why when did you encourage her to do drama?
I think it was exactly from that experience. Ukuthi when we hear ama artists most of the time, we radio stations, different radio stations, they would tell us ukuthi actually wanted to be a singer whilst I was at high school, bengifuna ukupursue music. Basabazali bami basa ngiqale ngibe uthisha ngenza i-degree. Then only mase ngithole i-degree would I be allowed to follow my career. Or nje mhlawumbe njengo Yvonne Chaka Chaka uthi wa-release iculo ladlala walicima ekhaya bengazi ukuthi uyena oculayo. You know, I had those stories and I felt ukuthi I think it is high time that as parents siye kuba i-old school. Ngoba what I have noticed ukuthi labantu abazalela ukuba ama-artists bagcina beyiwo whereas baqalela ufuna khona noma abaqalanga. Although ke angeke ngisho ukuthi akuqhamukanga nokusaba ukuthi hey lo muntu uma elento yakhe ingasalungi kanti akanayo ne-protection kind of uyabona siba naleyo nto ukuthi umuntu kumele abe ne-degree straight whether i-law noma i-education.
Something to fall back on.
Yes, ukuthi u-protected. Manje mevelenza lento kanti ayilungi futhi lento kuzoba kanjani kodwa ke I guess lento iya nangokuhlelelwa uNkulunkulu ngoba nobabu wakhe nje wavele waba positive sasavumelana sobabili ukuthi no sizoyiyeka ingane yenze into eyithandayo.
Wow, that's really cool. So we just wanted to thank you for that as well. I think abazali abaningi they don't do that, and we are really proud to ukuthi you as a parent were able to make that decision and allow her to be the person that she has she wants to be. And looking at her now and the things that she has already achieved and the things that she's still going to achieve, if it wasn't for that decision and that encouragement, we don't know where she could have been. We would have been deprived of the brilliant performer that she is. So siyabonga kakhulu ma.
Yebo, 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 qhiqha, siyabonga kakhulu mfethu. Usemsakazweni ngempela?
Ngisemsakazweni.
Okay, siyabonga kakhulu.
Siyabonga. I don't know, Mango, do you want to say anything?
Send some love on this Inspiwords podcast. no, ma, thank you so much. I really do appreciate it. Uguti, as abazali, bam, you know, you were able to actually allow me to do what I'm doing. And without your support,
yeah,
I don't think I'd be where I am today. Njengoba Dr. Mto Esh. It is really a privilege that you guys allowed me to follow, you know, my dreams. I really am who I am today because of your guys' support. I can't wait to collect awards with you guys on the red carpet.
Yes.
Yeah. I hope I'll be there as well to witness.
So I'm saving the speech gear for the awards that are coming.
Siyabonga ke mawube nobusuku obuhle ke nawe.
Amen, amen, amen. Ngiyabonga mfundisi, ngiyabonga.
Amen. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Wow, you guys want to make me cry? No!
Why would you cry?
No! No! This is such a beautiful moment. Thank you. Yeah,
it's really something that's worth celebrating because it doesn't happen all the time.
Yeah.
As your mom was saying, there's so many people, some are even listening right now, that desired to pursue their passions.
Yeah.
But because, you know, parents want to live out their own dreams through them, they ended up not doing what they wanted to do. But you had that privilege, you had that grace from God to have parents that would actually be the ones that are actually directing you to what is actually your passion and your purpose.
Definitely. Yo. And I mean, sometimes when I think to myself, I'm just like, okay, if there was a chance, if I had to do something else, what would it be? Hey, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I'd probably stay for like a few months after that. I'm like, hey, guys, I'm done. I need something else to keep me moving. It's such an honor. It really is an honor.
Yeah. Let's talk about the vet's experience now.
Yeah.
What was it like? What has it been like?
Yo, the vet experience. It's been tough. It's been fun. It's been interesting. It's been amazing. I've seen myself growing, you know, from that place. People have seen me growing. People have actually seen my talent starting from and actually recognizing, realize, hey, you have something. It was an interesting journey.
And what about the edge? Have you really gotten the edge or you've just been cruising?
No, I definitely got the edge. I mean, I know a lot of people don't know this, but I should have graduated, but I didn't.
What happened?
I was busy shooting other stuff.
Okay.
Me angabe ngibhala my exams.
Yo.
It was 2021. November, I was shooting something, and obviously that's during this exam season.
Exams time, yeah.
And there's this subject That's, yeah, if nje like focus nyana, if you just go left, I will slap you straight. So it was that subject ke for me. Yeah, I shame, I lagged. I was not attending classes. I was not focused at all. So I failed that exam. Mm. And then I had to kind of repeat my third year. Yeah, so the time when I was supposed to do my honors, mm-hmm. I was busy doing the other subjects. So the tricky thing is that I was doing all my fourth year subjects, like all my practical subjects, and then the other third year subject module that I failed. And then, so in place of that, I couldn't do my research.
Oh, so that's why you're doing the research now.
Yeah, so I'm only doing my research now.
Oh, okay. Yes. And that's good because it gives you all the time
to do the best research. That's how I'm like, oh, you know what? Actually, it's not bad. It's not that bad.
All things work out for the good.
You know what I mean? So I have all the time. Like for the first, because it's just a semester long. So I'm just doing it for this last 6 months. Mm. So the first 6 months, I was just busy cruising, just doing some jobs, just, you know, trying to put myself there in the industry. So yes, Vits definitely gave me an edge. It definitely gave me an edge. Oh no.
I'm sure that will lift up your spirit.
It is. Oh man. Yeah, this song.
About this song.
The story of this song is just funny, man. It was last year? Yes, it was last year. I forgot which holidays it was. Oh, it was just the weekend that I chose to go home. So obviously I'm surrounded by mountains and trees and whatnot. So I was just bored. And then I just go to TikTok, you know, I'm just like, let me create something fast, just for 30 seconds, and I just post it on TikTok. And I'm like, okay, let me create. Okay, what can I do? I say, I'm answers. King of Prussia. I take my phone, I record. I think I did like two takes. Mm. I did the one. It was longer, and then I was like, it's just too long. Let me cut it. And then I did this version, and then I sent it. So, okay, let me send. And funny enough, the laugh part,
because I think that's like the best part in the song.
And it's so interesting. The laughing part, it was when I had forgotten what I wanted to say. Not that I forgot, like I was like, okay, now I don't know what to say. So like, okay, I forgot now. Where's the laughing part? Then I laughed, yes. Then I sent it. Okay, cool. And then I was just going on with my life. Then that week, I'm attending class. I can hear my phone is vibrating. Hi, so I don't mind. Obviously, I'm trying to focus on my lecturer here. Mm. Okay, then it's break time. Then I go TikTok. So I'm thinking, it's just those normal videos. Hey, I go in there. Yo, all these notifications. Hi, bo, what's happening here? Hi, bo, next thing, I'm tagged. Comments, likes. Hey, it's, my TikTok is buzzing.
Yo.
It's buzzing. And then I see the remixed version, obviously, like the what's this called? The sample of this song, basically. Mm. So Uyani, who I'm featured with in the song, he basically took my vocals. But it's what he was doing really in his page. He just randomly took people's vocals or whatever it is, and then he just put beats on them, and then he created this magical stuff, and then that's what he did on my song as well. I was like, whoa, this is so cool. I really yeah. liked it. I was like, this is so nice. I wouldn't have thought. What? Just a song that was just thinking.
It's a beautiful song.
Thank you so much. And I was like, oh, okay. So I carried on with my life and said, oh, wow, this is nice. This is nice. I'm not thinking anything beyond this. Hey, so manja, people are coming to me and they're like, no, we actually want the song. We actually want you guys to release the song. Please come together and record something in the studio and release it like as soon as possible. So I mean, I'm like, no, come on, guys. Nah, no. And also, I mean, it's people commenting there. They just hyped up. I mean, I get it. That's a nice. Hey, now the pressure is getting worse. People are
really, worse.
Yeah, people are just like, no, we want the song. So we keep in touch here with the Yan, and then he was like, yeah, I do want us to actually collaborate and let's actually record this thing properly and release it. Mm. I was very hesitant.
Why?
Firstly,
because I think like people would jump at an opportunity. Like
true. And I mean, I did it because of peer pressure, honestly. shame. If it was just me, I really don't think I would have done it. I wouldn't have released it.
But why?
I wouldn't have. Yeah, no. I mean, for me, you know, musically, I don't want to be out there. I don't want to be like, I don't know how to put it. It's so weird. Like, I don't want to be like a record label musician. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to record. Okay, I can record, but just for fun.
So I don't want to make a career out of it, basically.
Basically. I feel like in music, it's worse. The root of music is too hectic. Mm. And I feel like I wouldn't be able to stand it.
I see.
You know what I mean? And also, I was at a point where me as a musician, I'm still not sure exactly where I stand. Like, what type of music am I actually going to produce for my people? You know,
see.
What type of genre am I? I mean, I know I'm a soulful, jazzy person, you know. Mm. I mean, I can do gospel as well, but yeah, no, definitely I wasn't going to record gospel. No.
Why?
No.
Yo.
No, I'm going to sing at church, yes. Yeah, we're going to praise the Lord at church. That's it. I'm not going to release a song. Maybe Benjamin Dewey can feature me. Benjamin, you know? Maybe Joyous.
Mm.
But not like a full-time thing that I'm going to like release.
Mm. So in all your creativity,
yes.
What is like the thing for you?
So in the music side of things, like I had a vision of, you know, having my own band, you know, performing in like restaurants, and busy, Dr. Mtabisi, they're busy having their own meeting. Mmangaliso is just standing there in the corner, just singing, you know, just loving music. If you want me to book, if you want to book me for your wedding, yes, you can book me I can come and perform, but not something that's like out there, like, oh, man's just releasing. You know, that wasn't my vision in the music department. Acting, anything.
So what is the production that you would love to be part of?
Oh, Ushaka.
Ushaka
Ilembe, bro. I wish I was there. Oh, I wish I was
sure.
there. I was just recently listening to the music that incorporated into Ushaka, and I'm just like, whoa. And that's what I want to do.
Oh yeah.
Yes. Let me create music for me acting in that movie.
Mm.
You know what I mean? I'm acting there. Music, move my pal. Let me score music for you guys.
Mm.
Let me sing for your movie. Let me close it up for you. Let me be the open title sequence. You know what I mean? So that's what I want to do. That's what I want. Ushaka, I wish I was there. Oh, I wish I was there.
Mm.
I wish I was there. It's fine. It's okay.
Since that one has already happened.
Yeah.
Since that one has already happened, which one would you be part of? Maybe like the kind of productions that are already going on.
Are
coming. Or people that you would like to work with in the industry.
Yeah. I don't know if you know Cynthia Erivo. Cynthia Erivo is one of my she's just an icon for me.
Mm. What is it about her?
Her voice, she's just magical. She's just a magical person for me. She's just a star. Mm. Like Mmangaliso figure, like, yo, I'd collapse. She's just such an inspiration to me. She's such an all-rounder, man. Her voice, her acting, she's versatile as well, flexible. Mm. I just love that about her. And I kind of see myself in her. You know, it's like, ooh, yeah, I want to be that. I want to be that force, you know. And during my last showcase, I did a song that Cynthia performed in her play called The Color Purple. I performed that song for my exam. And it's one of the hardest. Like whenever I listen to it, I'm like, yo, this song is hard. It needs so much range. Like it needs so much, yeah. And at first, I was like, yo, I'm not ready for this song. Like I can't. I know one of those when you listen, like, Angiko ready. This is not too difficult for me.
Yeah.
My musical theater lecturer was like, no, you can do it. Like, come, if you want to do it, come, we're going to rehearse, we're going to do it. I prepared in my head. I was just like, and it wasn't a thing that I wanted to do it like her. I was like, okay, obviously I can't do it like her. And if I do it like her, I'm going to spoil it. Because, you know, it's not going to be as perfect as hers. I was like, okay, I need to. I actually posted it on my TikTok. Yo, it was, I think that's one of my, like, best performances that I've done. Adverts. Yeah, I burnt that stage there.
That's great. And it really seems like you're enjoying what you're doing.
Oh, yes.
And that's really great.
Oh, yes.
Let's wrap it up. There is a young girl, young boy, listening to this conversation.
Yeah.
And they are in the crossroads of deciding what is it that they want to do with their lives. They probably want to be in the performing arts industry that you are in, the entertainment industry, music, drama, theater, but they are scared.
They're scared.
What would you say to inspire them, to encourage them?
Yo, it's hard, man. It's hard. It's a very difficult industry. It's very challenging as well. And whether you have the vision of where you want to be, there's still going to be a lot of stones to pick. There's a lot of hurdles. There's a lot of jumps. There's a lot of oceans that you need to jump over. You know what I mean? But there's also discipline. Mm-hmm. You need to have a lot of discipline here. Yeah, there's no child's. It's not a child's play. This thing, you know. But I also feel like it's as challenging as anything. Whether you want to be a doctor, there's challenges there.
Definitely.
You know. Whether you want to be anything, there's always challenges. But I mean, if you want to go for something, go for it.
Mm.
Because I think with passion, when you call to do something, whether you hide it, you know, it's just like Mama Eshuguti. People did bahamba babo togotela bahamba babo utishela, but they always came back to what they wanted to do. So don't waste your time. Go for it. Go for what you want to do. Consult. That helps because that creates support. That creates support system, you know, because without support system, you're gonna go through depression. You're gonna go through a lot of stresses. There's a time where you feel like there's nothing going on. There's no opportunities opening up for me, and you feel like you're stuck, you know. But you need to constantly keep yourself going. You need to feed yourself the whole time. So if you have the right connection, if you have the right support, I think that's where it's at. Yeah. Watch the things that you want to see yourself into. Read the books that you, you know, feel that they inspire you. Follow the people that, even the people that we follow, Abo Cynthia, they've gone through a lot of,
a lot
of challenges, but also it's work that have they've worked at from a young age, you know. So do your thing now, and as you go, you continue to grow. Even now, I'm not where I want to be, but I'm continuously growing and seeking, you know, help wherever I can get. So go for it.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mango, for joining me. This was quite an exciting...
It was very exciting.
Exciting moment. Very insightful. I got to learn a lot about you. It was also nice to talk to your mom.
That was the highlight. That's actually the highlight.
That was a highlight as well. Yeah. So please go follow her. Go check out her work. You'll definitely be inspired. If you're one of those people that want to get into... the performing arts, she's one person you need to follow.
Wow. Nzobuya foot.
Yes, I think you need to come back because we didn't talk about the skits that you've done. Which were quite interesting. And I don't know why you stopped. So you didn't talk about that. We didn't talk about the cover that we did together.
Yes. Oh man.
I should get that video and actually put it in the podcast. Nah. Thank you so much.
Kubonga min.
I actually didn't ask who is the person you were talking about in the song.
You need to
come back and explain.
No, there's no need for any explanation, guys. I was just being creative. I was just being free.
Really? Your mom is not going to listen. It's okay. It's a safe space.
No, I was thinking of someone like in my future.
Oh.
You know, someone that.
Somebody in the future.
Yeah, in the future.
Is there anybody that is...
I'm saying so that we can slangana over the mountains.
I see. Why? That's a nice way, very diplomatic way of putting it.
I had to be creative, you know?
Wow, this was...
Hello, Inspi family. Thank you so much for watching the episode. Please do not forget to subscribe, share with your contacts, comment, and give a big, big, big thumbs up. Until next time, continue giving your dreams a chance.